We are disturbed and alarmed by the spate of violence, hate speech, and intimidation perpetrated against our supporters and members in various parts of the country by people identified as members or supporters of the All People's Congress. We condemn these acts in the strongest possible terms and call on the government and the security sector to take all steps necessary to guarantee the protection, safety, and security of our members and members of other political parties across the country.
And at the end of the day, the presenter told me to wait on the studio. And as soon as I want to move also, Samuel came again and said, wait on the studio. I said, why are you guys keeping me here? I thought they wanted to discuss something with me. But they continued to keep me on the studio. I said, no, it's getting late and I have to be leaving this place. And so Samuel told me that, no, we don't want you to clash with those guys. And I said, what guys are you talking about? So I had to later realize that there are a number of talks that we have brought around the complex of AYV. And so they would never wanted me to go out for any to avoid any confrontation and all the stuff. So later, Ms. Valnora Edwin herself saw them, and she even promised to make that publicly and also report the issue to the police. So later, the AYV staff came. They wanted to actually move me with one OSD. I said no. The visibility now is poor, and I don't also know their strength and capability out there. I cannot risk it. I would have to wait for my own men I trust to actually get me out of the situation. So I called the organizing secretary and some of my guys here who went to rescue operation.
Mina Sayo Ture, one of Samuel Benigu. And after we, Samura Kamara Komoya, he goes Samuel Benigu, who campaign. He goes through them, police and soldiers. With the reach, I'm going to Barre, from Barre now, and scatter inside the town. And you, we the SNPP member them, they begin to harass we, they begin to beat we. Me that the number one person, where they hold me, they beat me. They even wound me in my head, and they won't put me high.
I'm in August. Yes, I say, boys and boys together. So are they from a distance, I spot them, and I say, I say, they were business, they forget their business. I say, long not go there. I say, if we not go, how we will stop them? So I left behind a meter, I moved some distances, 50 meters. When he reached, so I seen another boy come up from the back, he wap out his stick, then a stone and he fall down. So in it, let me say balance a bit, but he said me pump out now, the fear will already happen. So I balance, but beware me, SFP people. Now he come to me, say, police green, that's a little problem. I say, if me afraid as a political figure here, then that. But then before I could recall now, all were stone. So I'm a friend, I ain't draw myself, and I ain't give me this polo from Friday. Up to this close away, me goes and everybody. Because it's up to now, they surround me, goes and they kill me, they burn me, goes and they kill Tama.
In the face of these attacks, intimidations, and hate speeches spewed by APC stalwarts, President Ernest Bai Koroma has remained conspicuously silent. In fact, there's a definite silence from his end, giving the impression that he either support the attacks against other Sierra Leoneans who are not members of his political party, or he is unmindful of what happens to them. As president, we believe it is his constitutional responsibility to provide security and protection for every Sierra Leonean, irrespective of party, ethnic, or regional considerations. We therefore call on President Koroma to unequivocally condemn this act and ensure that this ugly incident do not lead our country into ethnic and political conflict. We would also like to remind the political leadership of the APC that they will be held individually and collectively responsible and accountable by both national and international laws for their actions or inactions during and after this election cycle. We call on the leadership of the security forces, especially the armed forces and the police, to remain professional and not to allow themselves to be manipulated by politicians. They have to focus on their traditional role of providing security and protection for all Sierra Leoneans, irrespective of partisan affiliation.
To do anything for them, let them go and get their own children. You, the youth, are not future leaders. You are the leaders now. Stop being used by these hungry politicians. We in the SFP will continue bringing out these issues for the attention of the world and for the attention of the country, because we value peace. We know we are the moral guarantors of the peace we enjoy today. And that is why we are bringing this out. We are naming some of them so that the press can take it very seriously, so that wherever they are, it might be identified and taken out or advised to stop intimidating our people. As we go about, as we go very close to March, to the 27th day of March for the final elections, we are still committing ourselves as a political party to very peaceful, transparent, and credible elections.